The foreign minister has accused China of spreading disinformation as she calls for sweeping reforms of global bodies. Marise Payne has also used her first speech since the COVID crisis to take aim at the World Health Organization's handling of the pandemic.
As the global coronavirus caseload climbs over 8 million, the foreign minister spruiking the need for global cooperation.
COVID-19 is a shared crisis.
Marise Payne delivering her first major speech on the post-COVID climate.
At the heart of successful international cooperation is the concept that each country shares, rather than yields, a portion of its sovereign decision-making.
It's a shift of emphasis from the Prime Minister's rhetoric during his Lowy address last year.
We will decide our interests and the circumstances in which we seek to pursue them. We should avoid any reflex towards a negative globalism.
The PM tasked DFAT to audit Australia's engagement with global bodies. Now Marise Payne argues
Australia's interests are not served by stepping away.
Instead, the Morrison government will seek to reform institutions, the first priority, the World Health Organization.
Australia wants to see a stronger WHO that is more independent and transparent.
Marise Payne says governments must be able to rely upon information given by global bodies during a pandemic, taking a swipe at claims the WHO is beholden to China.
Let's be clear. Disinformation during a pandemic will cost lives.
And that clear message extends to China, calling out Beijing for warning students and tourists to avoid Australia due to racism.
The disinformation we have seen contributes to a climate of fear and division, when at a time like this, what we need is cooperation and understanding.
Trudy McIntosh, Sky News, Canada.